Hello everyone, my name is Fabian Eckermann and I'm a PhD student at the Communication Networks Institute of the TU Dortmund University. And today I'm going to talk about cooperative validation of camp position information using cellular vehicle-to-everything communication. This talk is structured as follows. I will start with the motivation, and after that I will explain our approach, the basics of our work, and the simulation design. After presenting our results, I will conclude the talk and give an outlook for future work. For cooperative applications like automated driving, as shown in this image, position information is vital. That also applies to robotic search and rescue or exploration scenarios with multiple agents, such as the shown scenario where robots cooperatively scan a big shopping mall after an earthquake to find for buried disaster victims. If the robots work autonomously, position information exchange among them is necessary. Cellular vehicle-to-everything communication is based on cooperative awareness messages, or CAM, that are basically periodic status updates containing, for example, position data. Therefore, cellular V2X might also be of interest for robotic applications. If fraudulent position information, for example, due to a malfunctioning GPS module is transmitted, safe operations might not be guaranteed. So the validation of position information is an important security feature, as it can detect those technical failures and therefore maintain the integrity of cooperative applications. For our approach, we assume that the vehicles or agents that exchange their positions using CAM are synchronized, for example, via GPS, as standardized for CV2X, and that they know their own position. When a CAM is received, the start of the message is detected and can be used to calculate the propagation delay. With this delay, the distance between the own and the received position can be estimated. If we combine the estimations of multiple receivers, we can also increase the confidence of this estimation. So how does the signal detection at the receivers work? At the receiver, the received signal and known reference signals that are also included in each CV2X transmission are correlated. Exemplary results of this correlation are shown by these two figures. For regular message encoding, the strongest signal path is used. For free space environments without reflected signals, this will also detect the line of sight path as shown in the left figure. But due to multipath propagation, the strongest signal path is not always the direct path, which is needed for the range estimation. This is shown in the right figure. We therefore implemented a lightweight loss detection to find the direct path within the correlated signal by extracting local maxima and saddle points. As shown in the right figure, the loss detection is able to detect the direct path within the correlated signal. The ranging precision depends on the sampling time of the receiver, as this defines the spatial resolution. For 10 MHz cellular vehicle-to-everything communication, a sampling rate of 15.36 MHz is defined, that is equal to 65 nanosecond sampling time. This will give us a range granularity of approximately 20 meters. In our paper, we investigated two different approaches to validate positions. First, a simple but inaccurate range matching approach, and second, a triliteration approach that is more accurate but also more complex. Both approaches will be explained next. For the range matching approach, we classify positions as valid if the distance to the received position and the estimated loss range are close. We hereby expect that distances to accurate positions coincide with loss ranges more often than distances to erroneous positions. By this approach, each receiver can classify a received position autonomously. It is also possible to combine the classifications of multiple receivers to a majority decision. This is a very simple approach with no computational effort other than the loss detection. But the geometrical relation of multiple measurements is not used, unlike our second approach. For the triliteration approach, The loss timings of multiple receivers are aggregated to trilaterate the sender's position. Therefore, the exchange of estimated ranges between receivers is necessary, which can be done, for example, by an extension of the CAM format to contain the past measured ranges or via secondary communication links. Let's have a look at the iterative trilateration scheme. We assume that we have a multipath environment like in this figure. The white dot is a sender and the colored dots are receivers. Our initial solution comes from linear approximation. As we can see, the indirect path received at the red receiver adds a localization error. Using an iterative Gauss-Newton optimization, enter outlier removal that detects the receiver whose estimated range contains the biggest error, the positioning error is decreased. More details on the approaches can of course be found in the paper. If we now want to analyze the validation performance in simulations, we need the following models. First, a traffic scenario model to generate positions that lead to ranges. Then a receiver sensitivity model to gather message reception probabilities. And finally, a channel model to simulate the timing detection of received messages. For the simulation of the cellular vehicle to everything physical layer, the MATLAB LTE toolbox is used. The figure shows the receiver sensitivity and the resulting distribution of the block error rate. For the receiver sensitivity, we try to replicate the results of the field experiments presented by the 5GIA as good as possible. For the further simulations, we fitted a block error rate model based on the shown block error rate distribution. This model, as well as the other models created in this paper, are fitted from 1 million simulated physical layer transmissions. For the timing detection, two channel models are combined. For the fading channel, the EVA model, as proposed by 3GPP, is used, and for the path loss, an ITU vehicular model is used. In this figure, the delay tabs of the EVA channel model and the distribution of the signal detection offsets for the strongest signal path and or loss detection approach are shown. As expected, the timing detection offsets coincide with strong delay tabs of the EVA channel model. For the further simulations, we used Gaussian mixture models to generate timing detection models based on the offset distributions. It is also shown that our loss detection improves the timing estimates by recovering the loss delay for many of the received messages. For the generation of positions, a big highway with 10 lanes is used. Further simulation parameters, such as the detailed parameterization of the cellular vehicle to everything communication side link, are listed in this table. As classification is a statistical problem, one performance criteria used within this work is the classifier sensitivity, also known as the true positive rate. In our case, it describes the proportion of invalid positions that are correctly classified. The other statistical performance criterion is the classifier specificity, or true negative rate, that describes the proportion of valid positions that are correctly classified. In addition, the trilateration error is defined as the difference between a trilaterated position and the position contained within a received CAM. For the classification, the positions tolerance describes the difference between the CAM position and the estimated position, above which the CAM position is classified as invalid. So this is the smallest error that can be detected by the classification. Let's have a look at the results for the range matching based classification. We can see that the classification has a sweet spot at 80 meter position tolerance, where both metrics are above 50%. This is in fact the only area where this approach is better than guessing. The results of a majority voting that combines the two votes of multiple receivers are shown in the second figure. Here, and of course also in the first plot, The areas where the classifier sensitivity is high, but the specificity is low, many false positives are detected. If it is the other way around, false negatives are detected. For the sweet spot, the ensemble confidence is boosted to up to 80% depending on the traffic density. For the trial iteration approach, better results are expected. If we look at the trial iteration error for different traffic densities, we can see that the trial iteration becomes more accurate if the number of receivers rises. For high traffic densities, the maximum trial iteration error decreases from 50 meters to 22 meters. For stable traffic densities, that is 20 vehicles per kilometer per lane, a median trial iteration error of 10 meters is achieved. If we use these trial iteration results for a classification, we can see that the area of false positives is small and that almost no false negatives are detected, as invalid positions are classified with around 99% confidence. And for high traffic densities and a 20 meter position tolerance, the classification is almost perfect. To conclude this talk, I will summarize our work. We proposed a position validation without additional hardware and little computation and communication effort to validate CAM position information. This leads to a security gain without extra costs. For future work, we want to improve our loss detection by using machine learning approaches. The difficulty of this idea is the risk of overfitting to specific channel models. And of course, if compatible cellular vehicle-to-everything hardware becomes available, real-world measurements would be of interest to validate this simulated approach. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me under the given contact information.